Hello everyone, welcome back to Fire Emblem Three Houses, where last we left off, we completed another month and got my Swordmaster skill class unlocked. And I looked up online for the different stat attributions of going from Swordmaster into a higher tier. And it's not very good to go any higher than where I'm currently at, because Master classes don't really give you better stat distributions, at least the ones I'm going for. I'm better off just staying in Swordmaster because I lose out on the speed increase. I think it swaps it over to luck or something, but I don't really need that. So I may just stick with Swordmaster for the rest of the game. As for the others, I still want to give them mounts so they have movability, but it really makes it a bit simpler to go through. And I didn't think I have anything I needed to do before going off to this mission. So we'll check my battalions that need to be filled. Not. Any repairs required? No, I think I sorted all of that out last time. As for me, I need to... Actually, I'm fine where I am, so I can just throw things into the Envoy. But I've attached the Knowledge Gem to get faster skill and mastery. At a certain point, I won't need it, because it doesn't affect teaching. But let's head off into this mission. Say, Investigate Remire. I also had some missions to do in the Null Paralogues, but I could do that anytime. Well, I could do that next month. I'll have time for it. Go straight into the mission. That's the second 13-month resub today. Thank you, Arco. Following along with Sniper. Level 15 seems a bit low. Flame in the darkness.
We've got to go now.
Good day, Ed.
The situation in Remire Village has changed drastically. We don't know much more than that. We're hearing reports that the villagers are killing each other. Some say houses are burning. Regardless, we need to move.
My control.
Kill! Kill!
Ah! Yep, my control. She's a zombie.
Help! Somebody please help!
What's going on here?
This is unbelievable. There's no way to tell who's lost their mind from who's mad with fear.
If we don't act quickly, things are just going to keep getting worse. Get involved here, but we can't leave these people on their own, right?
How about we hit him hard enough to knock him out, but not hard enough to kill him?
That's too reckless, but I'll admit I can't think of a better option.
If some must die, just know it was by the will of the goddess.
Fuck
off.
Stop
that, Marianne. We have to save all of them. There's no way this madness is by the will of the goddess.
Nobles are responsible for the safety of the commoners. By the honor of House Gloucester, I swear that I will save them all.
Claude, there are some strange-looking people here.
So you noticed too. Look, there's a suspicious group hiding amongst the villagers. Could they be the culprits? If so... There you have it. Our objective is clear. Take down that suspicious group and rescue the villagers.
Second chance trigger style when I went to the cutscene. Yeah, it's got battle music. Even though second chance trigger is from Arknights, I think. I think it's from Arknights. Actually, no, I don't think it's from Arknights. I think the picture for the music video of it is Arknights, but I think that song is just from Cabal Minds, which just made the song. Ooh, chest. Ooh, another chest. And what's this? Healing. What's that? Okay, it's just a bucket with nothing on it. And a wall. Okay, so just two chests on the left side. In that case, I could just send Ignatz after both of those. Ooh, Tomas. Tomas has been a bad boy. I assume I have to try and save as many people as I can. Oh, there's Dayed. Now I can go to there. This is red. Can I still go through? Only by flyers, okay. So I need to go around. Natural terrain, so that's fine. I can go around that way. Kind of have to move him through that area. So the rest of this is, yeah, flyers only. As for this one, flyers. Recovery. Okay, so go to there and then go straight up here and go through to there. Might be better off sending Lorenz with a key. He already has one. Okay. Ace Lorenz, you go over there. That way they can split up, because I don't know if Dayed is just going to end this without us. Not one of the casters in the front. I have the I Felix, that's fine. Who has Catherine? Raphael has Catherine. Yeah, sure. Fight. Geralt, don't you fall in.
There are some suspicious looking ruffians out there, but our top priority is to rescue the villagers. Got it?
Eh.
I'll rein in the villagers who've turned violent. You focus on rescuing the others.
I don't wanna. I don't feel like it. Okay, so we do need to go to the outskirts. In that case, just have you buff up our speed. You don't have that. You have the speed buff? Yes, you do. Okay. That's gonna be the best one to do, I think.
Thank you. I stand ready.
Ready anytime.
Oh, nice, you can get just behind this one as well.
I'm so sorry.
So much for holding back. You're welcome.
I got this.
Ready and willing.
Who, me? Let's get to it. That's the spirit.
I was expecting a crit, but I'll take it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Stay focused.
They are going straight for the villagers. You gotta be real quick to save everyone on this map, then. They're running away.
It can't be. The one giving orders to those weird ruffians. Isn't that Tomas?
I'll hit three of these guys. Yes, you'll do that.
Why me?
Yeah, sure, attack a barricade.
Tomas, what in the world are you doing here?
He's having a little bit of fun.
I'm not Tomas. My name is Solon, the savior of all. What's the matter? So shocked you can't even speak. You were so easily fooled by my disguise. I was hiding away in Garrick Mach to get the blood of that little girl called Flame. With her blood, we'll be one step closer to realizing our goal.
Gotta kick his ass. More people! That's a Death Knight again.
I'll have a bit of fun here too.
He's mine.
That's the Death Knight. He must be an ally of Tomas, or Solon, or whoever he is.
Thank you for going for me and not the civilians.
Thank you.
Not so fast.
I guess one way to go about this is just going straight for Solon so all the villages are saved. Oh, Geralt's just a saying there. Why did you walk towards him? What's behind box number one? Giant shell. I guess I'll give us defense up. I can move up, attack, and then move again. This is difficult. Can I still go up there? Just gonna take an extra movement or something? Not much in the way of terrain I can use to get around here, so... there for now. He has two turns left of life. That soldier doesn't. Okay, I only have one more civilian actually to save. It's on the right side.
My blood compels me.
Jeez, 99 damage.
Thank you.
Alright, no civilian died.
We've rescued as many as we can. Now it's time to capture Solon.
But I want to kill the Death Knight for a third time. Okay, I can't go up there. If I move to here, can I teleport my character over? Yes, I can. Why did you teleport me onto fire? Terrible.
To serve Lady.
My flyers. Oh no, I'm going around this way to get to there.
From my best.
Take that.
Pointless.
I like how the horse just jumps.
Perfect not.
Yep, Geralt's getting in there, so I've got a timer on killing the big lad. Me to the left. Okay, brought me one diagonal. I guess that will be enough. It's not enough. How could you do this to me? Yeah, no spells for you.
Back to it.
Certainly can't kill this fella. I may not be able to get to that chest. So I do this and attack it. There.
Did that suffice?
My moment has arrived.
Put in the effort right there.
But victory is mine.
Try and wait out a bit. People keep messaging me. Alright. This side's all done, isn't it?
Yeah.
I want that chest and I want that death mask.
No hesitation.
That is that.
Yeah, a lot of crescent sickles. Oh, the Death Knight doesn't even want to come fight me.
You are a savage, insignificant beast. Yet you think you can kill me?
Apparently, yes. He's gonna die in one turn, so I'm not gonna be able to kill the Death Knight, I don't think. What's health you got? 45. Ah, Armor Slayer. Yeah, here we go.
My pleasure. Do your best to kill me with that blade.
You got it, dude.
My blade craves their flesh. The weak will eventually die.
It's a nice looking sword. But then I'm used to the training weapons.
Another step forward.
Dark Seal. That away. Why am I using my steel shield?
What anyway? In any case, we need to take care of Solon.
I should be using my knowledge gem. Why is it defaulting to the steel shield? That's annoying. Chest, please. For Slayer. Okay, well, that's everything. Can Annette get the kill? She could not. You can fist him to death.
Muscles proud.
Why have you gone after this village? What are you planning?
I could have conducted this experiment on any test subjects. Now that I have what I came for, I must bid you farewell.
Just gonna teleport away? Yep.
Wait! Damn it, he's gone.
Getting really pissed off with all of these games I'm playing where the boss just teleports away. I've had 3 people do it in Pathfinder today, then 2 here because Death Knight and Solon just did it.
It's over.
That's my gears.
All we can do is focus on our next move. I'll have a look around the village. There may still be people who need our help.
I indeed saved all the villagers. Just an extra large bullion I'm getting. I get about a CO2. Real annoyed I didn't get my double mastery and whatnot from that because the fucking steel shield out.
Looks like we somehow managed to sort things out, and casualties were kept to a minimum. They said they weren't picky about who they used as their test subjects. Because of them, the people of Ramayr Village.
There you are.
Here I am.
That armor. So, you're the Flame Emperor.
Yes. I believe you have met my subordinate, the Death Knight.
I defeated him.
Oh, we've met all right. But back to you. You're the one responsible for the destruction of this village.
Do not get the wrong idea.
What in blazes does that mean?
It is true that I am working with Solon, but that does not mean our objectives are the same. Had I known they planned to do this, I would have stopped it. You have my word.
Your words are meaningless. Now, I'll have to insist that you accompany us back to the monastery.
I cannot abide that. However, if you wish to join forces, I will hear your plea.
What?
If left to their own devices, they will commit countless more violent acts like this one. Do you not wish to prevent that? With the Sword of the Creator on our side, Solon would not be a threat.
I'll join your cause. I will refuse.
Pity, though not unexpected. Pray that you do not live to regret your choice.
Gerald, Professor, have you seen Claude?
What's wrong, kid? Huh? Oh, damn it! He's gone.
Teleporting like the rest.
Hey, I've been meaning to talk to you. Since coming to the monastery, you've changed. You've been angry since we first arrived in Ramayr Village. And you look so happy when you're instructing the brats. Before the monastery, I'd never seen you bear your emotions like that. Not once.
Is it a good thing?
Then perhaps it's a good thing we came to the monastery. If only so I could see your face lit up like that. Or maybe there was never any reason for us to leave the monastery in the first place. I've put my foot in my mouth, haven't I? Though I suppose it may be nearly that time. Come to my office when you next have a moment to spare. There's something I need to tell you.
I was born of a goddess.
What was that about? I can't recall a time of old when you were at the monastery. I wonder what is hiding in the mist that is your past.
I'm a time traveler, and I'm also secretly the Flame Emperor.
Hey, Teach. That assignment wasn't my favorite, I've got to admit. I suppose pretending to be unaffected doesn't do anyone any good. That was terrible to behold. It's always hard to see innocents die. Hey, all you can do is keep smiling, keep marching. That's part of a leader's job. We can't give in to despair. Not just for me or for you, but for all of us in the Golden Deer House. We have to keep smiling so the others can move forward too. As long as we don't show that we're disheartened, they'll know they can make it too. That's what matters. Sorry for getting ahead of myself, Teach. That's how I feel, but how you handle it is really up to you. By the way, I hear that guy who calls himself the Flame Emperor showed up in Ramayr Village. I couldn't believe it when Hilda told me the news. What could he be after?
An alliance. We definitely was interested in the Sword of the Creator, so probably the Hero's Relics.
Maybe. After all, he was after the Sword of the Creator in the Holy Mausoleum. But then they kidnapped Flame and used her blood for their recent attack. Based on that, we should probably assume that their true objective is something other than the relics, don't you think? They called this incident an experiment, and they said they got what they came for.
That, table in the middle is bent inwards. You can also see the seam of where they lined up two images to create the 3D effect. Like, just to the left of the candle, you can see the cut-off line. Mostly because the circle around the candle that shows its light is immediately cut off. I'm not sure how they've done these backgrounds. I don't know why they didn't place us in the areas, because these backgrounds don't look much better than the 3D environments. That looks really off.
That means they might take this success and attempt something even bigger next time. Sadly, that's all we can assume. There are far too many things we still don't know. Flame, your timing is impeccable. Would you care to join us for a while, fair lady?
What? Why? Oh my.
Damn. She gave us the slip. In any case, I doubt she knows the full story. It seems more like she has something on her mind that she can't divulge. Seems like it would be better to push Seth for an explanation. Or, best of all, to go above his head and ask Rhea. Now that we know Tomas was an enemy, we can't be sure that exposing the church's secrets would be to our benefit. Where are the answers I seek? Where are they?
You did well handling that awful business in Remire Village.
Thank you.
I am certain the goddess shares in our grief at the senselessness of that calamity.
Probably not.
More importantly, I was shocked to hear that our own Tomas was actually a dark mage. I must reflect on our blindness.
You surely must. You failed to notice that a rat was hiding in your home. Pathetic.
Same for you, Sophus.
Who are these wicked foes? How did Tomas escape your gaze?
Tomas came to the monastery 40 years ago, by recommendation of House Ordelia of the Alliance. Around 8 years ago, he went back to House Ordelia, before returning to the monastery once again just last year. After having worked at Garrigmach for decades, why would he betray us now? Just what did he hope to accomplish? Yuritsa became a professor at the Officers' Academy because of a recommendation from the Imperial Nobility. Supposing that he is the Death Knight, that means that our enemy is an organization that has taken root in at least two territories.
In the long history of the Church of Seiros, no, long before even that, there have been an endless number of threats to the Peace of Fodlan. Yet those who oppose us still operate in the shadows. Their identity is a mystery. I believe that Solon and the Death Knight are merely one part of a much larger whole.
A threat to Fodlan's peace? That means we have no choice. We have to stop them all.
Nah, I'm gonna take a break.
I have truly come to rely on you. I believe that the monastery will remain safe so long as we have you. We do not yet know the enemy's objective or whereabouts. For now, please devote yourself to preparing for whatever comes next.
That is all for today.
Professor, please wait. I know there is much that you still do not understand. However, one thing is clear. You possess great power. I believe that you are destined to be a source of great hope for all. In any case, I expect great things from you. Walk this world proudly, dear Professor. May the goddess Sothis protect you.
The goddess Sothis? Is that what she just said?
Is something the matter? I see. Sothis is the goddess's true name. Please do not use it carelessly. Farewell.
Do not say something that we may regret. She... I... What exactly am I?
I guess it's fitting that a church is praying to a child.
Please, go!
Part 1. White Clouds.
Wait, so Ethereal
Moon.
Who is Seros?
The cause of sorrow.
So we're the Knights of Seros. Is Seros the location we're at?
Though most stars will still glimmer in the crisp winter air, the Blue Sea Star has gone back into hiding. Legend states that the goddess prays for peace from her home in the heavens. In the town of Garrigmach, the anniversary of the monastery's completion nears, and the people's prayers intensify ahead of the Millennium Festival, still 5 years hence.
Press the A button. Reminds you of Snipes playing Tomb Raider. Hold the jump button to bridge the gap. Hold the climb button to hold onto the edge. Looks like 5k is the maximum I'm going to be getting, because I've been getting that for the past 4 ranks of Professor.
Sorry to trouble you.
Professor? There's something I need to say. Thank you. How should I put this? I don't seem to be getting along with everyone. I don't contribute much either.
Says our best healer.
Am I a nuisance to you, Professor? If so, I'll leave. Of course, my adoptive father may not understand. But if I must... Oh, my adoptive father is one of the new nobles of the Alliance. His territory is to the north. He was a distant relative who took me in after my parents vanished. He's blessed with great drive and ambition. Some may go so far as to call it avarice. He wishes to marry me off to a powerful noble. That's why he sent me to the Academy. If I left now, I'm sure he'd have a strong opinion about it. Ah, sorry. I strayed away from the topic. I'm not good at telling stories either.
Definitely reminds me of Haru.
Good. I'm glad. So, as I was saying, are you sure I'm not bothering you, Professor? Oh, I'm so grateful to hear you say that. What I'm trying to say is, you should keep your distance. I'm more trouble than I'm worth. You only say that because you don't know the real me. I'm sorry, I have to go.
Alert! Alert!
We are planning a grand ball for this month. I'm sure the students will be most pleased.
It's not gonna go well, is it?
Certainly. However, we must not devote all of our time to frivolity. We have a new mission for you. We have found evidence of someone sneaking into an unused chapel.
Oh no?
No. There is nothing of value in that building. We do not yet know what the intruder's objectives are.
This month, your class is tasked with guarding the chapel and investigating these intruders. With the recent state of affairs surrounding the Holy Church, we cannot afford to overlook any abnormality, no matter how seemingly trivial.
I am ordering a seasoned knight to assist you to ensure the safety of the students. In times like these, I am afraid we must always expect the worst.
Is it Dayad?
Reporting for duty, Lady Rhea.
Yep.
I thought you two could use the time to bond. And to speak of important matters.
Appreciate the thought.
Bear in mind that Geralt has a separate mission of his own. He will join you once he has finished it.
It's true. I'll be away from the monastery for a while. But when I return,
You said it last
I'll
time.
I'll come and watch you work. I'll be looking forward to it.
You know, when I first saw Geralt, his design made me think he was just a random helper NPC and not my dad. Like, him just entering into the room is like, oh, okay, here's going to be Berserker Man or my right hand who's going to help me on the mercenary business. Nope, he's your dad. Okay. Before I can get... Equip that and put this into the storage. Like Crescent Sickles was better. I don't know how much the increased damage to horses. It's 80, 80, but that's crit. That's much better durability. Yeah, may swap that over. Though I should see if they can be upgraded. Plus, that adds crit rating. What about this? That adds might, so 10 be the same as that. If I don't know why this is B, I guess because of the durability, maybe? But this just turns out to be much. And it also has 35 crit. Yeah, I think this is going to be better. So I'll put away both of those. What's this do? Increase defense by 2. Well, 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 well. It might be better off to use it on Ignatz, because his defense is crap. Use it from here? Yes, I can. Yeah, I could also use it on me and just make my character a demolisher for everything. I am starting to take damage again, I guess. Yeah. All of the eggs into one basket. Great. Annoying. Store it's full of fish, so probably just extra fish per line cast out. And the others don't matter, so I can do quests here and then do the paralogues in the other weeks. I don't have a tutoring on the 22nd for some reason. Strange. There's a black magic tournament, so Marianne's up. Do some splurring.
Tomas. No. Solon, was it not? And the Flame Emperor. It is most clear that something has transpired, and it relates to you somehow. Or is the fault my own, and you're just caught inside the wave? Sothis, the goddess of this world. I bear her name. How confusing. I feel as though my head has turned to mush.
Just share the name. People can't have the same name.
Before the ball, it is customary that we host a competition of dance known as the White Heron Cup. The students are quite fond of this tradition. Each house must select a representative to compete. Their dance shall be judged by its beauty, grace, and technique. The student who is deemed the winner will be given the opportunity to train as a dancer, should they so please. It is a very precious thing, the gift of dance. I hope that you and your students will choose to participate. May I ask a favor of you?
The end of week two. Oh, they're gonna turn to some sort of bard. Okay.
It cannot be true that our siblings in arms could turn against us, so. However, I will continue investigating members of the church. To think that even someone as senior as Tomas would fall under suspicion. I know not how far to take my search. Unlike the monks, the Knights of Seros are Lady Rhea's direct subordinates. Some are in quite unique circumstances, but I cannot think any of them would betray us. I have a request.
Guess it's gonna be from Petra, maybe? Let's go back to my room and start from there. I've picked up the two quests I need. Yeah, Bridget. I think that's Petra's room.
The ball. A grim reminder of my sad reality. The other nobles will be fine, I'm sure. They've all been to events like this before. But me? I'm a noble and I've never even been close to one of these things. The ball. The other noble, but me? Sorry, I'm trying.
Strengthen bow. Or friendship. Wait till I get my lost items for this chapter. I'll see if I can relate to her. Let's just throw a lot of flowers in her face.
Oh, now where did that Ingrid run off to?
That way.
The ball is soon, and she hadn't even put on any makeup. I was trying to help her out.
Oh no, not having makeup. Whatever shall you do? It's as if you don't like the way you look. Gonna cover it up. Should all just wear masks, then we'll never know. You can only tell someone by what mask they wear and the hair they have.
Oh, great. Just great. It's that time when all the students get all lovey-dovey. You're new, but you know about the ball, yeah? I can't bear it. Young love is wasted on the young. They can't appreciate it to its fullest. Oh, I wish I could fall in love too. Oh, speaking of the ball, Professor, have you selected your representative for the dance contest yet? If you don't, the contest will go on without your house, and that would be embarrassing.
Can't remember any of the students talking about dancing. It's my professor level. It's B, but I want to know the experience I have. See if there's any chance of me being able to plant another seed. Lost.
You know, Professor, I used to think I would be comfortable with all manner of experiments, so long as they provided usable results. But when I heard of Solon's work, well, I realized I'd not considered the moral and philosophical limits of what all manner of experiments might mean. Sorry, I'm not great with blood. Even when I'm just thinking about it, I feel a bit ill now.
If you're hemophobic, what the fuck are you doing in a military academy? I just need to carry yellow cards around and just throw them on people when they say something stupid. That's a lot of moolah. It's like just going for many fish over the glittering fish events, just better. A higher chance of one isn't as good as getting three of a good one. The bobber we throw out lands very heavily. I apparently wanted to do a lot of goods in that one. Last fishing.
Yeah. the ball. It reminds me of how I met my wife. I was at a village's harvest festival. There was a full moon, bathing everything in its cool glow. She appeared out of nowhere, dancing gracefully in the moonlight. A lovely fairy. We soon fell in love and tied the knot. Now we have a daughter who's as bright and beautiful as a sunny morning. So, whenever I see people dancing, I think of my wife, and my heart does a little waltz.
We were gonna see your child? Hello, Mr. Nick.
Pardon me.
I cannot do that because of TOS.
Nothing to report. Other than the legend of the Goddess Tower, of course. Have you heard the students talking about it? On the last night of the Ethereal Moon, on the same night as the ball, if a man and a woman go to the Goddess Tower and make a wish, it's sure to come true. I have a wish, but I can't find anybody to make it with me.
Why can't I select Catherine? This is a bunch of balaki. Guess I've just got a default Leone then.
Greetings, on the lap, if a man and a.
Oh, I can change it. Okay. I can't make myself like Catherine anymore, and she's a higher ranked anyway. She's a B, whereas Leone's only a C. The game's just going against me. Look on the map for her, is there? Sad days. You're poor Annette? Well, you can love her. That'd be fine.
Hello there. This one, yes?
Have some silverfish.
This one, yes?
And some goldfish. I've got a few of those.
I thank you. This one, yes? I thank you. This one, yes?
Buy all the bait, because why not?
I thank you. This one, yes?
The inspiration for fishing may take me one day.
I thank you. This one, yes? I thank you. This one, yes? I thank you. This one, yes? I thank you. Return soon, please.
I don't know when I'm gonna be allowed to bring up my support level with Catherine. It's just stuck right now. I looked up, but they don't get any more points if they're stuck like that, so it's not gonna be giving her any more items.
Come again.
This one, yes?
Welcome. This one? Thank you. 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 This one? This one? Thank you. This one? Thank you. This one? Thank you.
Just please take all my again. Money. No, not this soon. Not this soon. Ah!
Thank you for the bits of this
what
one.
What do you require? Farewell.
Hello.
Is there a shinier sword? No. It's a weird coloration of that wood.
Inviting a girl from a different house to the Goddess Tower on the night of the ball.
But here's the twist. She's from a family with a much more significant and storied past than mine.
Who gives a fuck?
I wonder if she'd ever stoop to going out with the humble son of a knight.
Sure, why not?
Great work in Remire Village, Professor. Who would have ever guessed it was Tomas? But no. Now isn't the time to get lost in gloomy thoughts.
What's up, Professor? Hey, I got a girl waiting.
Mercedes locked me in her room for hours earlier. She was slathering pounds of makeup onto my face, saying something or other about the ball. It really wore me out. Hi, Professor. I've actually got plans.
Dare you.
I can't believe this. I'm so angry right now. First it's the Death Knight, and now Tomas, but neither of them are in custody. I can't stand the thought of such evil lurking in the world. We have to do something about this. I have to do something about this.
All right, buddy. You want something to take your mind off of that? Here, have a training weight. You like training, don't you?
For me? This is so great.
Here, have some smoked meat, too.
For me? This is...
You want anything else? Sadly, I don't think you think any flowers are nice. How about you join my house?
Professor? Here, no?
Shame. How dare you? I have plenty of strength.
Thank you very much.
Seems the dastards who set Remire Village aflame have yet to be apprehended. Monsters. Trampling mercilessly over innocent lives. They deserve a gruesome end.
You changed your voice.
Even though there is to be a ball, we still have a mission. It would be nice if this month passed by in peace.
Doubtful.
Heya.
Ah, the ball. It reminds me of my first such event, back in the Imperial Capital. It was held by my father, the Prime Minister. I really showed off my dancing skills. Everyone was quite impressed with me.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Professor. Well, the eldest son of House...
Dancing a Fodlan is not the same as dancing from Bridget. The reason is... maybe that the music has many differences. In Bridget... dancing is different for each person. Our dancing has vigor and ferocity. There is no speech of technique for our dancing. Training has given me great busyness right now, but you have given me intrigue. Please make sure you are speaking with me again.
A moment, please.
A moment for what? You're in my way.
Hey.
Hi. There's a certain gentleman I'd like to invite to a rendezvous at the Goddess Tower.
Do it.
However, I can't imagine he'd be interested in a sheltered ingenue like myself. It's hard to pluck up the courage when that's where my thoughts always take me.
I mean, if it's the guy down the way, he wants to ask you out as well, so let's do it at the same time.
Now, another month full of chaos. I've barely had time to catch my breath. What is the objective of Tomas and his ilk? And what makes Flame so special? Does that not bother you?
You should keep your eyes in your own sockets.
Everyone's in such a festive mood. I feel a bit out of my element here. I can't help but worry something might happen while we're all distracted. After all, our enemies are always plotting. Still, this air of levity is much more agreeable than the grim atmosphere of late.
Hi there! Legend has it that long ago, a female student from the academy met with a mysterious man at the Goddess Tower. They fell in love at first sight and were bound together forever after. But that's not the really interesting part. The incredible part is that the man was apparently the Adrestian Emperor himself.
Uh-huh.
What I wouldn't give to fall in love at first sight with a splendid and powerful gentleman. I want my own fairy tale romance, and I want it now.
My money, and I want it now. Wiping in the Vettel Guards. She's up her own ass. Bit bitchy. It's not really done much to sway my opinion otherwise. If I was in her house, she probably would have given me reason to not think so, but I'm not.
It's almost time for the ball. Oh my, am I excited! This being a school, we don't have many chances to get dressy. Oh, but first, the White Heron Cup. Who will appear on stage, I wonder? You're choosing the representative for the dance contest, isn't that right? Choose me, I'm a pro.
You're also a self-confessed lazy person.
Aw, I was really getting excited for it. Well, let me know if you change your mind, huh?
All right. Some scary things have been happening lately. I hope that this month, of all months, is peaceful. The ball is coming up and everything. Although I'm not much of a dancer, actually. Watching other people dance can be fun, though. I've heard people talk about the White Heron Cup. Do you know who will be representing us?
It is you! Put you on the stage.
I think a noble would make for a better choice. Bound to know their way around a ballroom.
It's true that Tomas was employed here under the recommendation of House Ordelia. But that's all I know of the topic. I'd never even seen him prior to enrolling here. Even when he was supposedly in Ordelia territory, I never once saw him there. I'm still feeling bothered by all of this, but there's not much else I can say about it right now. Right. It's the dance this month, isn't it? Can't see how anyone would be much in the mood for dancing, considering. Although I suppose the White Heron Cup does sound pretty fun. It would probably be more logical to ask someone who likes dancing in the first place, so I certainly understand.
She probably froze her fit on the stage, but she lost.
The long-awaited ball. Finally an opportunity to These skills were ingrained in me when I was a boy. From what I hear, the White Heron Cup will be-
Say
no more, Professor. I would consider it an honor to represent our class. By all means, take your time and think it over.
Nah, boy, suited. You're not doing it. What indeed? You, random girl, you'll be our representative.
Our life in Remire Village is gone. Father and mother, gone.
some dancing would cheer you up.
Why couldn't you have arrived just a little sooner?
If you dance, I can go back in time. Big Eater, I wonder who that is. Maybe somebody talks about food every second they can get and every second after that?
This is a rare opportunity to enjoy yourself. Please, leave everything else to us. The Remire Village incident, the search for Tomas, we have it handled. You just focus on enjoying the ball with your students. It's for the good of everyone, don't you think? If the professors walk around in a state of distress, the students will be uneasy too.
I came out here for another item.
I wonder if Remire Village will ever be the same again. How do you recover from such a terrible event? So many dead, so much destroyed. I can't see how the whole village doesn't just end up abandoned. Our class was also sent out to help put the village in order. But then... I do find you very...
I guess I should do some more tea parties for charisma bonuses. It's just they're kind of... plain. Straightforward, there's not really much to do. Also, just boils down to pressing A like 6 times.
I'm glad the Remire Village situation got sorted out, but it's not over yet, is it? And I can't believe old Tomas turned out to be an enemy. Who can you trust anymore? The ball? Doesn't matter, I don't dance. I might show up for the food, though. Not that it's got anything to do with me, but have you picked someone to represent us for the White Heron Cup yet?
It's you! And I say don't dance.
Well, someone's bound to want to do it. I'm sure we've got a few people with the talent to win, too.
It might end up being Hilda then, if she's the only one that's really showing any interest in it. It'd be simple if they just came to me and say, hey, can I do the dance, please? And I can just choose between. Why do I gotta do it?
The ball is coming up soon. I am so excited.
And you just can't
wait
have
to
it.
Fill up on food while everyone's dancing. I even heard there'll be some prime cuts of meat. Apparently, there's supposed to be a dance contest too. I think it's called the White Heron Cup. Who's gonna represent our class? I can do it if you haven't picked someone else.
Thank you for offering, Raphael.
Oh, really? I may not look it, but I'm actually a pretty good dancer.
Are you, though? I mean, I know he's good with his fists.
Right.
Fists enemies all the time. They can barely stand after they've been fisted by him.
The area with the old chapel was supposed to be off limits. It was at risk of collapse, so they didn't even post guards. It's not too strange. Does that surprise you? Meh. Garrick Mach has lots of places that are blocked off for one reason or another. That's true of the underground Holy Mausoleum, as well as the Northern Woods. People call it the Sealed Forest, but as far as I can tell, it's nothing special. Just a forest.
Can I have some training weights?
I'll take it. I love it.
This as well.
I'll take it. I love it.
Do I need to invite her to tea to progress support? No. This is going to take time, so I think I just have to wait for the chapters to pass by, sadly. No tower date for us. Darko, if you do know if I can have Catherine for this tower thing, feel free to let me know.
Hello there.
A simple yes or no will suffice.
Greetings. Ah, on the if a man and a
That's so.
Hey. What's this about? The ball. Knights don't participate. It's an event for students, but it does pique the interest of some knights in particular. Alois can't dance, but I hear he likes to watch. He volunteered to judge the White Heron Cup. Not that I care. Working hard, aren't you? I'll admit, I'm impressed. I can assist with any tasks or help with your students. On it. I'm available anytime I'm not on a mission with the Knights.
And there's another person for me.
Too much merriment. The librarian betrayed us. The Death Knight is back. Is this the time to be throwing a ball?
You like training weights, don't you? You know the end.
Aha! This is.
Not enough for you to join
people
my team.
People say you're quite skilled. Perhaps if I joined your class, I could watch
there
your sword
go.
Technique up close. Indeed, I think that's best. I'll transfer to your class then. Don't make me regret it.
Just stealing all the students.
Hey.
Person here? No? I think it's just the question mark for this guy. You. Huh. Oh, yes, use this holy magic. Gonna have you use Lysithia or Annette. They're forced to use fire. Check a look at the stats. I guess we'll go with Annette, just because Arco likes her. Ooh, I get double. Okay, 10, 20, so she gets one hit, right? That's fine.
Worked out.
When she gets two hits with 16, I should be fine. Heal. So 9, 18, 27. Okay, we'll get one hit on me. I don't know why he's allowed to use Blizzard and I'm not, but whatever.
That worked out.
Nine, 18, 27. I need 4 hits. 12, 24. I'm probably not going to win then, because she's going to be able to hit me twice. Wait, 9, 18, and again another hit 27, so she is going to hit me twice. Yeah, I need to heal, otherwise I go out and I'm probably not going to win the final.
Ah!
not survive one hit, so we lost. Yep, 16. Let's see if we get a lucky crit. Probably not. Try with Lysithia. She is an extra rank. A bit more health. So I may just have to not get the tournament for this month. Which damage she do? 15. Okay, she has a lot more then. Probably she's gonna be taking a bit more damage as well.
I just worked harder.
But then she also doesn't have the double hit, so she's technically one less damage. 13 twins. Damn. Not gonna be able to do this, doesn't look like.
You underestimated me.
Yeah, not gonna be able to do this. However, I'm gonna be right back. I have returned, and that intro sequence, I'd caught a glimpse of something, and it looked to be very spoilery. So, if that is what I think it is, fuck the game. Who else could do this? There's Hanuman. But this is the kind of game I might enjoy a New Game Plus run of if it wasn't for these lost items you gotta go hunt for.
Oh. Someone entered the old chapel. I think the townsfolk used it for feasts and such in the past.
With that whole Tomas business, you can't blame the church for being on edge. Considering this recent rash of strange incidents, I wonder if having a ball is really the best idea. And then there's the White Heron Cup. Sheesh. What poor sap are you enlisting to represent our house, Teach? You're a smart one, Teach. I think Hilda or Lawrence would be able to win it for us, no problem.
Yeah, it seems like it's gonna fall down onto Hilda's shoulders. Then she sleeps in and just forgets about the ball entirely.
So, Tomas the librarian was a bad guy? But he always seemed so nice. Oh, come on, Self, you're better than this. You promised you'd be on top of things this month. After all, we have the ball to look forward to, and the White Heron Cup before that. Oh, speaking of, have you chosen our house representative yet? If not, I'd like to volunteer.
Oh, I can have Annette do it, even though she's not a normal stand in my class.
Aw, that's too bad. Oh, but if you reconsider, you know where to find me.
I guess it's gonna be Annette then. She seems to be raring to go for it. And I trust her more than I trust Hilda.
Hey you.
Let me in! Let me in!
Oh no. What happened in Remire was indescribable. The whole village burned to the ground. So many were left without even a home to return to. Thankfully, Her Grace the Archbishop has invited those who lost everything to stay at Garrig Mach. I pray that they will be able to return to their once peaceful lives as soon as possible. Until that day, we of the Church must join together and do all that we can to help them rebuild.
She likes being told to get out of her shell.
Really?
A ball? I don't think I'll partake. There's a dance contest as well? I see. I'll cheer for our class, of course. So, who will represent our house in the contest? I'm sure whoever represents our class will do a fine job. Much better than I could do.
Hello, Professor. The ball will soon be upon us. Ah, I can feel my heart fluttering already.
I have never danced in front of people before. Not even once in all my life.
I am very much looking forward to it. Have you heard yet about the White Heron Cup? If you have yet to choose a representative, do you mind terribly if I volunteer?
I mean, if you've not danced anyone before, you might get stage fright. I've already kind of chosen Annette, so...
Understood. Oh well. Either way, I am still so excited about the ball.
How about I give you a flower to forget about it?
Wow, I am delighted.
You can have another one as well, tons of these.
Oh.
Need something? This one? You're all set. This one? You're all set.
Seem to be changing that much.
See you again soon.
Run like the wind, Bullseye.
Hello.
What?
Is this the tower they're talking about? Assume that's the tower.
You there?
Maybe.
Pardon me.
Oh no.
Last month was, well, you know even better than I do. I hope this one will be more cheerful. This ball, though, I don't know. It's all new to me.
Might I offer you an egg in this trying time? Or a violet?
Wow, I can have this? Huh? You're inviting me to... I'm really flattered, honestly. But I...
Stop barking at the cats.
Professor. Hey, Professor, what's going on? A suspicious man. Where? Oh, is that him? What do you think he's up to? Never mind that. Let's get him. Keep watch. So boring. My instincts tell me that he's up to no good, and my instincts are never wrong. Come on, let's get him before he has a chance to strike. There's no time to calm down. I'm just gonna... Oh no, the path he's walking down leads to the plaza where the kids play. There's no way I'm letting this guy get anywhere near those kids.
Maybe he's a dad.
Kaspar, why did you disobey your professor?
I
am not seeking excuses from you. I asked because I want you to consider your actions and apologize for them. It just so happens that you were correct in your assumption that this man was a villain. If that were not so, he would not have chosen to take his own life upon seeing you advancing toward him.
Great! So I was...
But, because of your actions, that is all we know. There is no way for us to know who he was, what he was planning to do, or if he has allies lurking about. The only lead we have is a scorpion tattooed on his arm. If this indicates that he was a member of an underground organization, we have no way of dealing with it. Are you prepared to be held responsible if his group commits a serious crime? Oh, I couldn't possibly.
What are you talking about, Professor? We didn't do anything wrong. Those kids might have been in danger if we didn't act. I couldn't just stand by and let that happen.
That kind of didn't really end. Okay. We have another one. Is it with Casper again?
Hey, hey.
Professor.
No, Sylphlane.
It has been a while since we last spoke, Professor. Spare me a moment again, will you not?
Oh yes, a choice of nothing.
You recall how you helped me and allowed me to join your class, yes? I have learned a great many things since then. Indeed, I have truly grown so much. This personal growth is due in large part to you. And I wish to express my gratitude, sincerely. Excuse me? Are you implying that I am still naive?
Yes.
I will have you know that I have made many friends and am constantly learning new things. Why, when I go to the market alone, I even haggle. You must be familiar with the delicate art of haggling, in which one negotiates a lower asking price for an item. That is the type of knowledge common only to those as mature as myself.
If you say so, dearie.
Who? Me? Have you not asked this once before? It is a bit rude to ask repeatedly, you know.
Yeah, you never told me.
Is that so? Well, it seems we have something in common, since I do not know your age either.
My character doesn't know either.
There is nothing to be gained from focusing so heavily on age. Touching on a previous discussion, I think I have learned more about you. I mentioned how you possess an air of mystery. I compared you to any old sea, but I have come to realize you are more like a particular sea, one I have seen before. When I was quite small, my mother would take me out to play in the sea. She was an excellent fisher, my mother. I grew to love fish deeply because of her. Well, you see, fish are... Wait. I was talking about the sea, was I not? Anyhow, I sense that, like the sea, your depths are seemingly impenetrable. Yet, despite your unknowable depths, there is something familiar about you. It's as if we have met somewhere, long, long ago. No, I do not think so. It is all quite strange, really. I wonder if we might be distant relatives. No, that cannot be it either. After all, if we were related, that would mean... Though considering all that Rhea has done, it is not entirely outside the realm of possibility.
You're a bit too green for me.
Oh, apologies. Just muttering to myself. It is nothing. Mutterings aside, I mean to say that you do not feel like a stranger to me. For whatever reason, I feel deeply connected to you. And for this, I am glad.
Do I have any more support things to look at? Takes time. Big time. Ooh, Hanuman. Go find him. Taking time. Okay, just Hanuman. And now he's up here, so it looks like I'm needing to go through a list. Or it only has one on the map at a time, I'd say.
Professor. Ah, Professor. Always a pleasure to see you. I wonder, might you have a moment to chat? Come now. You have no need to be on guard. I'd never cause you harm. You're far too valuable a specimen, well, that is to say, too valuable a member of the Academy staff. Indeed, the further my crest research progresses, the closer you come to learning the truth of your heritage. Is it not so? When I learned you bore the lost crest, the very crest of flames itself, I set about learning everything I could about your past. What was the origin of your bloodline? How have the events of your life been shaped by your lineage? I became somewhat upset.
My destiny and my lineage!
Nothing so crass as an investigation. No, I researched. I spoke to mercenaries whom you've worked with in the past to learn about your life before the Academy. Of course, I also contacted Gerald and his mercenary friends. Your father does keep rather interesting company. I'm excited to share with you what I learned, but I do ask that you correct me if I am mistaken on any account. The story begins with Gerald serving as captain of the Knights of Seros. There was a woman at the monastery with whom Gerald was quite close. At first, it seemed obvious this mystery woman was your mother. Alas, that cannot be the case. The timing is all wrong. As it was told to me, the woman in question passed away shortly before Gerald left the monastery. Yet your birth occurred sometime later, while Gerald was taking work as a mercenary. This, of course, presumes your age is accurately reported. If you were born sooner, well, the story would be quite different, would it not? Oh, I am aware. You two were certainly enigmatic, as far as mercenaries go. For example, Gerald never once spoke of his time serving as captain of the Knights. That's quite a secret to keep for all those years. In the end, your old acquaintances had little definitive to say about either of you. However, they all agreed on one thing. Your father and yourself were a strong pair, warriors to be respected and feared. You in particular. In fact, many came to know you as the Ashen Demon. They say you would destroy your enemies without a hint of emotion on your face. The mercenaries I spoke to revered you as a living legend of sorts.
And yet, I was only level one. I don't know why they say ashen, though. I guess because I wear black clothes.
That is what I learned. And I admit, it is barely more than I knew before. The next step in my research is to ask your blood for answers, and hope that it is more forthcoming than your past acquaintances.
Okay, looks like all of the meetings done. Now to finish off exploration. And then figure out who these lost items are gonna be for. You'll finish me off, sniper? Alright. Sounds good to me. We'll just need to wash our hands, because I've been carrying some flu-ness around your house.
Really?
Oh my.
Nah, Tomas wouldn't betray the church. I don't believe it. I won't believe it. There's some people in the church who hate people like me who are from Almira, but Tomas was always real kind. But if he really was Lady Rhea's enemy, well, I'd defend her against anybody, no matter how kind they'd been in the past.
Tested positive an hour ago? Oh, well, that's shit. I thought you and your wife both tested negative last night, or two times in a row, and you said you both clear. I guess it snuck around somewhere on a fabric. You may want to do a clean of your bed sheets and whatnot so it can't go around again.
Indeed. Garrig Mark Monastery is said to have been completed during the ethereal moon. Why, 995 years ago, as a matter of fact. That's rather a long time ago, don't you think? Every year, a ball is held to celebrate the founding. And every 100 years, a very special celebration takes place. It's a grand festival involving all of Garrig Mach. It is thrilling to read of past festivals, and I'm rather excited to experience one for myself. Once in a lifetime, eh? The next one in 5 years will mark a millennium. Should be quite an event. Do you imagine you'll still be here teaching then?
Possibly. Dayad isn't even in his office. He said to meet him there. Oh boy, more fish knowledge. That was 500 professor experience.
Into Tomas, but I just cannot make sense of this at all. From his behavior up until now, I never would have suspected that a man like him could turn on us. I have also discovered that his appearance has changed. It is almost as if he is not even human. What in the world is going on?
Now the question is, do I want to use my time to get faculty training or not? So I'm at B+. It looks like AE can go to A+. But I don't need them for my advancement classes anymore because I'm probably just going to stick with what I have. So I think it might be better just to spend my time getting professor experience by doing singing and food. I may do that. However, I need to check what gifts I have.
Each half a student, it is a fit.
Or lost items, rather. Okay, so a book of ghost stories. Who likes ghosts? Button. Oh, Felix wants to chat, I guess, because he's now in my class. Maybe he's gonna have something new to say about the ball.
Too much merriment. The librarian betrayed us, the Death Knight is back. Is this the time to be throwing a ball? Whatever. What's on your mind? You look like you're about to say something. Are you considering me as our representative for the White Heron Cup? I see. That's a relief.
Let's go choose a net, just so people stop asking me that question.
Oh, speaking of, have you chosen a... Really? That's fantastic! I'll try as hard as anyone's ever tried. You can count on it.
Speak to Manuela. Give them dance lessons. Okay. Where is Manuela? I was looking for Mercedes. Give her this item. Over there. Maybe Manuela's over there. I think she was complaining about people being in love. Cities.
Oh, now the ball is... Oh, this is mine. Thank you for returning.
Anything else for you? No. So next is an unfinished score. Who likes to sing? That is Annette. Go to Anwello's only here.
Oh, I hear you've chosen your representative for the White Heron Cup. In that case, a word of advice. On an average year, the winning contestant has about this much charm.
Usually around 13. Okay, so 13 and above. I'll just get it as high as I can with her then.
Charm is important, wouldn't you agree? Who wants a partner with no charm? Not me. Do your best, make sure to put in the practice, and good luck.
If that's the case, it seems like it doesn't matter who I choose then. It'd just be better to choose whoever has the highest charm. Which would have been me, because I have 23. 20 for Claude. Lorenz has 11, so he would have been a good choice as well. Raphael's 10, so he's fine. So is Ignatz 11, 10. Marianne would have done it at 13. Hilda 20. Jesus, she would have been a good choice. Leonie's also 20. Felix is 11, so he's fine. Annette has 13. Okay, Annette will be fine. I'll just do a tea party with her and do a lesson just to give her a bit extra. And Flayne is also 20. I have a lot of candidates for being a good dancer. Okay, and that has a new discussion option, probably to some dance training.
Professor, would you watch me dance really quick? I've been practicing a ton.
In the 2 minutes I left? He's just spinning around. I guess I just press A to end. Increased by 5? Jesus. She's 18. She's definitely gonna win.
Well, what do you think? I'd say I'm pretty great, wouldn't you?
This unfinished score,
what
I guess.
That? I thought it was gone for good. How did you know it was mine?
Next up is Bluestone, which I think would be for Ignatz. Let's have a tea party, just give you some charm. Not able to make it? Well, screw you! I'll get back, Arco.
Scary things have been happening lately. The ball is coming up and oh, that's why.
Does like painting. A lens cloth. Is that just gonna be for, Hanuman. Was it his office?
Indeed. Derek, why? Every year, it's a once in a life. I can't believe I left this behind. Oh, thank you so much.
Evil repelling amulets. Say Ash. Cool woman who carries fishing tackle and net. Of course. Where was Ash? Site. Could go this way.
Last month, the spa.
Hey, I've been looking for that.
Who secretly likes dolls? Lysithia, probably because she's hiding her childish nature.
Even when I'm still...
Hey! That! That's mine!
Crude arrow heads. Most likely going to be for Leone, since she's shown to have the bow. Even though she wants to move over to Lance.
Pardon me.
Draw a precise location of her. On the outside. Yeah. Here she is.
I'm glad the reminder, but I can't. Oh, that's mine.
Old fishing road. Setif. Too big, 5 point. Yeah. Too many classes, 7.8 out of 10.
I have looked from his. I have also. It is almost.
Oh, my gifts, lost items.
Yes, this is.
Can't remember his name. I'll know him when I see him on the map. Gilbert, that's it.
It cannot be.
For Shamir?
Hey, what's this at the ball? It's an event. Alois, he volunteered. Thanks. How did...
The guy, name I forget. And heart, you magic. Kinda.
Professor, you know, Professor, but when I heard. Oh, thank you.
It's fitting, he's also at the, the fishing area. Big spoon. Yep, Raphael, of course. Is Raphael actually going to be in the dining? He's not in the dining hall. Where the big man, Raffy? Oh yeah, he was outside this place. Remember him?
Oh.
Right.
The ball's...
I can't...
Oh,
that's gonna be Zero. Zero just cleaning all the time, doesn't think of anything else. If I can find where he is. Upstairs. Somewhere. Are we in the hallway? Yeah, he was in that room.
Oh my.
No, there's some, but it's...
Church stars probably gonna be rare.
Before the each half the student, it is a fit. Yes, that is.
Alrighty, that's all the lost items. Wants a discussion, apparently.
Welcome, Professor.
Oh, strange to your bedroom,
I
see.
This is the first time I have welcomed you here, is it not? There is no need to be nervous. Please, come closer. When
well,
you
well,
speak
well.
With me here in this room, you are not speaking with the Archbishop, but with Rhea. It's just me. Such a sweet child. My apologies.
I'm 20, is that a child?
I should not be treating you like a child. As Gerald's kin, somehow you don't seem at all a stranger to me. Speaking of Gerald, may I ask if he ever spoke of me to you?
I don't remember him saying much about you, besides he didn't want to come back here. Sure, let's pick up your ego.
Is that so? Unfortunately, I am unable to believe that such words fell from Gerald's lips. I want you to know that you are free to speak candidly. There is no need to spare me from the truth, however harsh it may be. Since you are here, shall I tell you about the Gerald that I knew? By the look of it, you haven't heard much about his time at the monastery, have you? When I first met Gerald, he was quite young. Why, he could not even grow a full beard at that point. On one fateful occasion, the band of mercenaries he belonged to fought alongside the Knights of Seiros. I was traveling with the Knights at the time, and Gerald jumped in front of an attack meant for me. He was gravely wounded, on the verge of death. I tended to his wounds in a desperate attempt to save his life. Thankfully, my efforts were not in vain. Gerald managed to escape a seemingly certain death. I made arrangements for him to receive further care at Garrick Mock. The moment he was deemed fully recovered, I invited him to join the Knights. Well, it is not a story I have often repeated. Even at the monastery, there are not many who know that. I tell you this because, to me, you are the child of the one who saved my life all those years ago. And also, never mind. It is nothing. I simply wanted to say that I trust you. By coming to visit with me today, you have... Well, suffice it to say that my day is brighter than it otherwise would have been. I thank you for that.
Well, welcome for my presence. Where am I going for Sedef? Back over here. He's sharing the same area with, Hanan. Okay, wasn't he? What? Oh, God. The doors didn't have an animation, they just closed and opened. No in between.
Professor. Ah, there you are. I apologize for calling you in so suddenly. Please, sit. There is a matter I would like to discuss with you. I believe I've told you this before, but it is my responsibility to aid the Archbishop in all her duties. Spiritual instruction, ceremony oversight, donation management, all of the church's many administrative tasks. I oversee not only the priesthood, but also the Knights of Seros and the Officers' Academy. The Archbishop entrusts a great deal to my discretion, and I am honored by her confidence. Even when she must make decisions herself, she often seeks my counsel in advance. And yet, your appointment to a teaching position at the Officers' Academy was a complete surprise to me. Not only that, but you have also been entrusted with the Sword of the Creator. I was as surprised as anyone else to learn that. Frankly, I am just not sure how to handle you. I am the Archbishop's right hand, and yet when it comes to you, I have been told almost nothing.
I like chili.
Not quite. I do find you to be a trustworthy individual, but my subjective opinion is not enough.
5 minutes to politicians of Switzerland to tell the public the actions against Russia. Can't wait for a list of weak sanctions. I did see a news headline about there was some missiles shot today, or yesterday. But they were in a meme channel, so I don't know if it was fake, or they're just pasting it there because they couldn't think of a more appropriate place to post missiles being launched.
I have a duty to be cautious. Should the Archbishop's trust in you prove to be misplaced, it is the faithful who will suffer most. First, I would like to know just how much you know about yourself. You are the child of Gerald Eisner, correct?
Ukraine, yeah, that was it. I can't remember the other side. Officially in the war? Oh boy. Well, it's a lovely time for it.
That's quite a vague reply for such a basic question. In the future, I would advise you to answer such queries with confidence. As the former captain of the Knights of Seros, Geralt is renowned throughout Fodlan. If you really are his child, then no one would voice any complaint about you joining the Knights. How long has it been since you became a mercenary?
It was nice to wait until media got bored of COVID. Depends what media you're watching. People like to dramatize it and then just not talk about it and then bring it up again. It's like, oh, we didn't put too much notice about COVID. Now it's all gone wrong. I was a mercenary for 10 years. I was a mercenary from 10 till 20. That, I guess, I didn't do fighting for all of those 10 years. Could have been doing training and cleaning the weapons.
Given your youth, that hardly seems likely. Come to think of it, I have never asked your age. Just how old are you exactly?
Early 20s, possibly dead on.
Your face says it all. You truly don't know, do you? Just what was Gerald thinking, raising you this way? Given your responses thus far, I feel as though any further questions would just be a waste of our time. However, permit me to make one thing clear. Whatever her reasons, the Archbishop has placed great faith in you. Do not betray that trust. That is all.
I mean, if you tell me what the year is, I can work out my age just through maths. I know I was born in 1159, but that's it. I don't know what the current year is, no one said it, and it's not in any books I found.
Pardon me.
Hell, if they even tell me when this monastery was built, I can just do maths of 995 years, and then that will give me the current year. doesn't know how old he is, but he knows how long he's been a mercenary. I mean, 10 years just could be his cognitive memory. Like, you don't remember much from being a child, but you remember your teens and above. He could just be saying he has memory of 10 years before this point. And at that point, he knows he was living in tents and whatnot, which would have been the life of a mercenary. Maybe our character answered it as in him having a life of a mercenary, but not actually acting like a mercenary. But who knows? You'd have to ask the developers or the story writers on that side of thing. Eat some food. Chances are I can guess how old he was 10 years ago. It depends if our character is remembering his mother died at 1159 and he was born just before her death, or she died giving birth to us. So we were born in 1159. He just needs to be told what the year was. He wasn't even told what the goddess was until he came to this place, so I don't think he even knows the current year.
Like a tasty meal after some grueling.
There is no need to rush.
Make anything for experience gain. No, they're just buffs, sadly. Alright. Wasn't much else in the way of eating for that. So I'll go to singing for the others. But I don't think we're going to get enough rest of experience for the, Kuchimi Flip and the whatchamacallit. You know what I'm talking about, Rhea. The seeds.
This is no good. Sing from your...
There's someone who's slightly off. Oh well, that adds some color, I suppose.
Guess I'll make some food for the others to get all their motivation up. Oh, Cloud didn't get happiness from that for some reason. So I need Cloud and Felix. There we go. Cloud and Felix.
That smell.
That looks appetizing.
Manuela. Looks like all my other students are fine. Cordelia, I need to max her out.
That looks. This is a.
I could possibly grind fishing, but I'm gonna need to catch 100 fish. No. If I get 30, yeah, I need to catch 100 fish to level up. I don't want to do. I guess we'll just do. I'll just plant the things now, and then it may give me an extra. Well, I don't get the extra points straight away, so it's not much to worry about doing it now. Ooh, speed. That'll give me like 400. do the rest in singing for Professor XP. It's ended. How could you? It still says it's soon to enter the get dance contest. I have. Quest thing over here. I can check it there.
Oh no.
I guess it's waiting for the dance to occur.
Professor.
I guess it's gonna wait until the dance happens then. It's already have. Didn't see Rhea. Do I need to tell her again, even though I already spoke to her?
Before the ball, each house must the student who is deemed the whip. It is a very precious.
There's no option, so I guess, yeah, done with that. Yeah, sure, train me. Double check that. Okay, that doesn't give me experience, that's fine. Let's just double check with Annette that I can't do another training session. Or tea party. It might just be that I can't do tea party for the whole day.
Well, what do you think?
Oh, okay. In that case, small food. There's a meeting to be had outside this place.
Professor? Professor, a pleasure to see you. I've never been very good at praying. I was here to confess my foolishness. While I'm at it, may I confess something to you too? I realize what a burden I've been. On you, I mean. After every breakup, I neglect my work, and I know how that affects you. I'm completely worthless as a woman. Can you imagine how that feels? Oh, I'm going to be single for the rest of my life. I just know it. You think so too, don't you?
Well, from the way you go about it, you kind of seem to want one-night stands, even though I say otherwise.
Really? So if I couldn't find anybody else, you'd marry me?
My heart belongs to somebody else.
Oh, don't worry. I can tell by the look on your face you didn't mean it. What's wrong with me? It's not my looks. I'm still gorgeous. Or am I? Be honest. Do I look old? No, not possible. I'm the songstress who swept the Empire off its feet. Men professed their love for me hourly. It can't be my looks.
I mean, the amount of stuff you caked on yourself? Nothing to worry about there.
I knew I was right. I'd be in real trouble if I weren't this beautiful. Oh no, if the problem isn't my looks, and they are not the problem, then it must be, what? My personality?
Yes. I can't give her a direct answer, sadly. Yeah!
I know you're trying to find a way to say it gently.
That movement of my eyes.
You think there's a problem, don't you?
Yes.
I suppose I can be a bit unkempt. I do have a short temper, and I may be a little lazy sometimes. But I've always heard fellas, you know, like a woman with a few flaws.
A few.
It seems to me there are plenty of flawed girls who have landed themselves a good man. So maybe my trouble is I'm not imperfect enough. Do you think I could use a few more flaws?
Ah, yes. The choice of one thing.
Are you saying I'm perfect as I am? Come now. You'll make me blush.
Be sure it's not the makeup you put on.
Yeah.
another thing popped up, did they? Do I have anything for... Not too sure what these up arrows are for. I guess it's friendship level. Sure. Ash, you can come help me. Do anything for defense. One defense, sure.
I love to cook. What are we making today? That's so.
We are making flames.
I have a lot of experience in the kitchen. I can make just about anything. Wow.
Can I do more than one?
Eating food always.
I would be liking that greatly.
I'll go check the gatekeeper, see if I can give it an answer now or not. But I'm having a sneaking suspicion. I'm not allowed to choose Catherine. Nope, but I've added. Did I add Hilda to the list? I added one person to the list, and I remember I only had four. Alright, check the map just before I leave. Nope, okay. I give such little experience.
Well, that would...
Train Annette's mage skill. So close. And Hilda's axe. Just so I have one person for each of the different weapon types.
I have a question.
Yeah, bring along a snack. I don't care if you're eating my glass.
What a wonderful idea!
As long as you have enough to share with me.
Professor.
Do Ah yes, I'm a magic caster. Please, let me change to Lance.
Oh, shopping took longer than I thought. It's a good thing I had your help, Professor. Looks like we've got everything we came for. Time to head back to the monastery. To tell you the truth, I wasn't sure if the money that knight gave us would be enough. We managed to scrape by, though. I'm glad those shopkeepers were willing to strike a few bargains. It's one of the few things I'm really good at. I've got a lot of experience living in the city. Money was tight for me, too. At least until Lenato adopted me into his family. Come to think of it, you were originally a mercenary, weren't you? I'm sure you've traveled all over Fodlan. That must have been a pretty different life from regular folks like me. It sounds a lot more exciting, though, traveling the world from conflict to conflict. But a mercenary's whole job is fighting, isn't it? Must be a pretty tough way to live. Wow, I guess you must get used to it. That's really incredible, though. Ah!
Ah? Uh-huh.
I had no idea they sold this book around here. I haven't seen this one for ages.
I like the metallic corners it had.
Lug and the Maiden of Wind. It's a well-known tale of chivalry in Fargus. Lug is the King of Lions. This book is full of his exciting adventures. I've loved this since I was a kid. It was what got me learning to read.
Give me that book!
Hey, Creep. Don't touch the merch. What the? Somebody catch that thief. Cut him in half like my prices.
Can I have Anna in my class? I'm sure there's quite a few people who would benefit greatly not being in Military Academy, but I want her in it.
Please, calm down, ma'am.
You calm down, kid. If he gets away with that valuable merch, it'll be a huge loss for me.
Here, allow me to compensate you.
Huh? Are you serious, kid? I mean, no objections over here, but that sounds crazy.
Don't you worry. That thief will be paying me back just as soon as I catch him. Head on back to the monastery, Professor. I'll take care of everything here.
Gotta give Ash a golden star next to his name. You have nerves. Here we go.
What is it? Did I do something wrong? Thanks so much. Hot, hot, hot. Huh? What?
Don't know much about her for this. None of those really seem to be good for her.
Come on. This was great.
Are you sure?
Let's show them the
dear goddess.
The power of training horses.
Am I making progress?
Before I go do some paralogue fighting, I'm going to be right back. I've returned. Oh, they added more paralogues. They're all at the same time. Do this one. I don't know if that's going to help with Catherine's relationship, and then we'll do oil and water because that popped up earlier. It's probably because they're entering my class that these are coming unlocked. But I have 2 months to do these because we're currently on December. These run out on February. I wish I could change the order of their dates because they're doing it wrong.
There you are. I have a request for you. It has to do with that plot to assassinate Lady Rhea. The bishop leading the Western Church was somehow involved. Enough is enough. So now the Knights of Saros have been tasked with putting the bishop down. I thought you and your students could come with us. Because you wield the Sword of the Creator, Lady Rhea is going to personally execute the bishop. I have been appointed as her guard. I want your help protecting her. So, what do you say? Will you come?
Excuse me. I'd like to come along.
I mean, you're
Ash,
my student, so yes.
You're listening in? It's not up to you whether you can come along.
Please, this is important to me.
Your adoptive father, Lord Lonato, had connections to the Western Church. I understand that you want answers. But our objective is to punish, not to investigate. We can't let you jeopardize the mission.
I won't get in the way. I promise.
What do you say, Professor? Keep in mind, we would be bringing the whole class, not just Ash.
Yeah, he's in my class.
Thank you so much.
Okay, I guess it's fine. Get ready then.
I can have him kill his own father. It's foggy! Suppose I can't see chests through fog. I can't change his equipment, but he's in my class. Is he in my class? No, he's not in my class.
Trying to pass herself off as the goddess's envoy. Archbishop Rhea, I'll bring judgment upon you in the goddess's stead.
They're using the fog as cover to ambush us. What a cheap ploy.
It won't do any good to get annoyed, Catherine. That voice. We are up against a faction of bishops.
They've shown themselves at least, so we won't have to go to the trouble of finding them. All right, you got a death wish? Come at me! You really want to fight against Thunder, Catherine? Please, Professor, don't let Lady Rhea get hurt. Our mission isn't just to wipe out all the enemies, but also to protect Lady Rhea. Ready?
You got it.
Here goes.
Sorry, stay focused.
Ready anytime.
I got this.
I stand ready.
I'll crush them all.
Just group up around her. We can die.
I'll give it my all.
Let's get to it.
Ready and willing.
There's a lot of knights in this corner.
As expected.
I am maturing at a rapid pace.
Kind of a terrible level.
Each battle a chance to grow.
Get the killing blow so she can level up a bit.
Ready or not?
Thank goodness.
At least you got magic.
That's the golden deer for you.
That's a nice spell.
Lady Rhea! Hold the line! Don't let them attack Lady Rhea again!
She took no damage, it's fine.
Magnificent. Naturally. I am still far from my... Magnificent.
salvation.
Is there any more enemies over here?
Takes care of that. Can't get comfortable.
A knight? They're going for him. Yes, they are.
States will suffer the punishment of the goddess.
Now the bishop is south.
Progress suits me well.
Shall we dance?
I like that dodging attack he does.
It's not luck, it's fate.
So close.
Here goes. That worked out.
That was a good Jesus.
Good try.
I don't have.
Never underestimate an outsider.
Steady now. That helps.
Guess I'll go down and kill a bishop. That was a terrible level up for you. There's some over to the left. That looks like you've been hit.
Thank you.
Where did he move to?
I stand ready.
Unless he is in that corner, I just can't see him. There he is. Yeah, he's still in that corner.
Maybe I'm not cut out for this.
Alrighty. First time I've had to use that.
I'll give it my all.
I stand ready.
Stay focused.
Apostates, you sully the name of the goddess.
Is the fog gonna go?
You are the apostates. The goddess is with me.
Sadly not.
Let's get to it.
Now where did this bitch come from?
I don't know.
Here goes.
I'll crush them all.
Giving out the XP.
What's done is done.
Oh, there's another boy there, so fist him.
Sorry, don't know my own strength.
And another one.
Ready and willing.
There goes a net, sadly. There goes Marianne.
Ready anytime.
I'll back you up.
This should work.
You.
That's how it goes.
Got a good hit on them. Elder's fine. There's a lot of people over there.
My efforts have
no skill for being A rank.
I'm all sweaty.
Is what I do.
Just let me at him.
Goddess, have mercy. Forgive them their sins, and save their souls.
It would have been better if we'd captured the bishop, but they didn't make it easy for us. What now, Lady Rhea?
We must go to the headquarters of the Western Church. Perhaps there is still someone there who knows what has transpired.
Let us help too. It may not be much, but we'll do whatever we can.
I am sure you will be a great help. I am glad to have you by my side.
I thought I had one more turn. Dissolve the wind. Don't increase movement by one. I'll take that.
Thanks, Professor. I really appreciated your help with the investigation. That's it for today. Head back to Garrig Mach. The Church will have to choose a new bishop and do whatever else is necessary to rebuild the Western Church. Lady Rhea is grateful to all of you. She said she would send along a reward. You should feel very proud. Receiving a gift directly from Lady Rhea is exceedingly rare. Still, that was a real mess, huh? For them to come out and charge us so boldly.
It was worth it for the extra movement.
As am I. We kept Lady Rhea safe, thanks to you. Hey, where did Ash go? I haven't seen him for a while. That may be it. I hope he's not getting in the way. There you are, Ash. We were just talking about... Why the brooding expression? Hey, what's that bundle of papers in your hand?
This was given to me. It has to do with my family. I haven't finished reading it all yet. But I think it might offer some clues about something I need to know. Professor, Catherine, thank you for letting me come with you on this mission. I'd better get ready to go.
It's a little painful to watch. I do hope that those papers, whatever they are, will help him get over his past. I suppose it's time for us to start heading back to the monastery.
We gotta do another mission. More movement. Actually, can I look at support now? A sec. I can look at them in. Yeah, still take some time. Oh well. Just because we had this earlier.
It's raining, Professor. On rainy days, the wound I got from the Death Knight hurts like fire. Every time it aches, I get angry. You understand, yeah? I'm sure they had their reasons to kidnap Flayne, but still... Did they really need to stab me? What'd I have to do with it? They ruined my beautiful porcelain skin. Worse, they took off before I could stab them back. So rude.
That's rather enough, Manuela. Cease your moaning and give the professor a break.
Oh, stuff it, Hanneman. Unlike you, the professor has a big heart and listens to me talk about any problem I have.
More likely, your incessant ramblings offer no chance to interrupt.
Is that true, Professor? I knew it! You listen to me because you care about me, don't you? Ugh, go away, Hanneman. Leave us alone. And stop making me shout. It causes the old wound to hurt again.
Then perhaps you'd best stay quiet. Keep your emotions in check, I'd say.
Don't worry, Professor. We do this all the time.
Indeed. Manuela and I do not mix well. Been true for years. That said, if it were up to me, I would prefer speaking to her in a calmer manner.
It's not like I enjoy bickering with you. So maybe keep your mouth shut more often.
I state that which needs to be heard. For example...
I'm sorry, I couldn't help it.
Same, apologies. I am here because I have new information on the Death Knight's hiding place.
You run away full time?
You could have started with that.
Several students have reported possible sightings on the western edge of the sealed forest. While the authenticity of these reports has yet to be verified, it is still a very real possibility. I was thinking I would report this to Seth as a precaution.
What? Why? We can't be slow. He's going to get away.
Protocol on this matter requires reporting to Seth, then Lady Rhea, then...
Professor, let's leave this old geezer behind and get going.
Old geezer? I am barely 15 years your senior. I will not hear such...
Stop talking. Let's gather a team and get going. I'll go scout ahead. I'm coming for you, Death Knight.
Manuela, wait. It would not do to get yourself killed without someone to avenge you.
Hanneman's pretty tall. Oh, this is a big, big map. Oh no, it's just long. It's not that wide. But it's a... Yeah, okay, Manuela, what are you doing over there? On your own some? I don't see the Death Knight, though. But we're gonna go help her out. Oh, we really don't have a lot of people here to help. Need him for his speed. I need to train a big nut so you can go back. Would like my healer. Yeah, give more defense to Raphael. Works for me. Send him right, and then I can just go upwards.
Manuela's in a tough spot, Professor. Even if she's only got herself to blame, we cannot abandon her.
Sure we can.
We have plenty of visitors today. Let's stop their annoying rescue attempt.
I guess his helmet set off the rumors.
Now that is a woman.
Uh-oh, they've noticed me. Here they come.
I stand ready.
Stay focused.
As expected. Such power dwells within.
Beautiful level up.
Who, me? I can't afford to lose.
My turn?
Ready anytime.
Ready and willing.
I can't control it.
Let's take them out.
Should I have held back?
99 crit. One health for Ignatz.
Who knew?
I'll try even harder next time.
Thank you.
Naturally.
Keep pressing the wrong button to swap between characters. So much defense.
I won.
Not my first battle.
Have Lorenz go for the armored boyo if he could, but he can't.
Bunch of meddlesome losers. Maybe we should take a hostage for leverage. Capture that woman. We'll show them what the Death God Gang's made of.
Death God Gang? What kind of childish nonsense? Where's the Death Knight?
I guess I got the name mixed up.
Should I have held back?
Now!
I can't afford to lose.
More levels.
I wonder how much more.
How dare you not get magic?
Never underestimate an outsider. Life does.
It's over.
You fought well.
A new sword.
I think not. An offensive sight. You can't compete with me.
Let me paint you a picture.
I did it. I did.
Wait for her, just wait there.
We are the Death God Gang. We're all unstoppable.
Is that all?
Mean you're unstoppable if you never attack anyone.
Yeah!
is that?
Everything is ready. This is our chance. Magnificent.
Man, I almost died there, but she's probably gonna die to the fister. She kills
better
him.
Luck next time. More polish, never. It's all.
It was a good try.
Ooh, another experience gem.
Know what you're doing?
Keep her here, the other guy won't go for her.
Worthy of applause.
Enough of this nonsense.
Naturally. I thought I gave it my all.
Terrible level. Look over there, but I don't think he has any items that I need to care about. Oh, time to kill the boss.
Even I have bad days.
Manuela! Are you uninjured?
A few scrapes and bruises, but yes, I'm well enough.
That looks fancy.
How could anyone think that was the Death Knight? It was obviously just an ordinary bandit. Oh well, I may not have found my revenge, but at least we got to retrieve stolen goods.
Manuela, you unthinking fool!
Hanuman, I've heard enough already.
How bloody stupid are you? If that were the real Death Knight, you'd have new, likely fatal wounds to match your first. Do you know how much you worried all of us? You should be ashamed.
Oh, no.
Exactly. You are supposed to set an example for our students, yet you let emotion get the better of you?
You're right. So there, I said that. It's true, but... ugh. I'm sorry. I'll apologize to everyone later.
I should say I'm sorry as well. I lost my temper just now. I see you act so irrationally and I lose my wits. I care about you a great deal and wish to see you safe. Will you believe me?
Yes, of course. I'm the same way after all. I let my emotions get the best of me. Ugh, we're both too old to be shouting all the time. You're awfully quick to put a bow on this. Are you sick of us already, Professor?
Possibly.
You're part of this, Professor. We are the only teachers this academy has. No need for bickering.
Well said, Hanuman. Would you care to join me for a celebratory drink?
That sounds lovely. Perhaps a nice cup of tea is in order.
The question is, who should I give the other experience orb to? Nah. No, she already is doing faith and writing, so... it would make a difference if I said yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, my sincerest apologies for the wait. Thank you for gathering here on the eve of the highly anticipated ball to bear witness to... the Academy-wide Dance Competition!
We Welcome should win!
To the White...
we only needed 13, we should have 18, John.
The competition will be judged by me, your humble servant, Alois Rongel, and also the acclaimed former songstress of the Mittelfranc Opera Company, Manuela Casagranda.
Yes, yes, thank you. Oh, and it should go without saying, but I swear to show no bias to my own house. Got it? Good.
Last but not least, the glamorous assassin who does all of her dancing in the dead of night, Shamir Navrand. The three of us swear on our honor to judge the following proceedings with utmost impartiality and fairness. And with that, will the representatives of each house please make their way to the stage? Contestants, are you ready to dance? And is the band prepared to play? Very well. Begin! Time! That's all, folks!
Why are they doing it like a boxing match?
All three of you were fantastic. Now, let's hear what the judges have to say.
Oh my, let's see. I suppose I have no choice but to vote for the Golden Deer House. Your performance was exhilarating. My heart is still beating a mile a minute.
I vote for the Blue Lion House.
How dare you? I had above 13.
Nothing wasted.
Great feedback, both of you. Well then, let's see. Factoring in my own humble opinion, yes, we have a winner.
It's me.
And I will announce who it is right now, without any delay. The winner.
There's a lot of delay here.
White Heron Cup is the Golden Deer House.
I did it! Go me!
Once more, please give a big round of applause for our talented participants.
What do I win? Yay, Annette can now be a dancer. Sword dance combat art. Ooh, sword avoidance 20. But she doesn't use swords.
I apologize for the wait.
I swear Dimitri's voice has changed.
So it is. Ah. Ah. Ah.
Best choice of all of them.
Please, join me for training when you have the time. There's much I could learn from you.
Indeed.
Thank you for the treat. I had a wonderful time. I would love to do this again, if that is acceptable to you.
Oh no, I'm increasing his charm even more. We have another dance competition, results, he may win.
I can do better now.
I appreciate your effort.
Yep, just needed to wait for it to be done. I got it. Let's go check the abilities that Annette got from that. Now, It's plus 20 when using a sword, which he doesn't use because he uses magic. Shame. She also got combat art, which I need. Combat art. Ah, uses charisma. Alright. Well, kind of wasted on her. Oh well.
Whew.
Time to rest.
Hey, Raphael. This scene, why is it oddly familiar?
It's almost like this stuff is drawn to me whenever I'm in town. I'm just happy I can use my muscles to help out around here.
But isn't your goal to become a knight? Running errands isn't exactly a knight's job.
I heard that proper knights always help those in need. Isn't that right?
Well, you're not wrong, but I think most people would consider that only a small part of a knight's duty. A knight's main function is to fight and defend, don't you think? That said, I'll agree that helping anyone and everyone who needs it makes you a remarkably virtuous person, which is even better.
If someone virtuous becomes a knight, they'll be a virtuous knight, right? That's about as proper as you can get.
Yes, I suppose so. I, for one, would certainly look for virtue in any knight that I recruited.
So you're saying I'm the type of knight you'd want to hire for House Regan?
Absolutely. If I somehow actually manage to become the head of my house, that is. I can't see into the future, but you have my word that I'll do all I can to help make your dream a reality. That is, if you're actually able to let somebody help you out rather than helping out the whole world by yourself.
I'm not gonna stop helping others, but you can do me all the favors you want. All this talk of being proper is making me hungry. For my first favor, why don't you bring me a snack?
That's good to me.
Hey, Ignatz. Getting lost in your imagination again?
No. Today I am praying. I'm hoping that if I pray with all my might, she will appear before me.
The goddess, you mean?
Yes. Perhaps it's strange to think about such things.
Nah, you're fine. If I had the chance to meet the goddess, I certainly wouldn't say no. Especially your version of the goddess, huh? A total looker, isn't that right?
That's a disrespectful way of putting it. I just believe that she's a divine beauty. She'd have to be, considering how she mesmerized the people of Fodlan when she walked among them.
Too true. No doubt an incomparable beauty, that one. Funny to think that even now she must be somewhere, right? Well, I guess she's just floating on a cloud or whatnot.
Yes, indeed. Watching over us from above. And they say that someday she will return to walk amongst us again.
Well, don't mind me. You go ahead and get some good praying in. If the goddess appears, you let me know, okay?
What? No! If she does appear, I want it to just be the goddess and me.
It'll be way better if I'm there too. I'm saying this for your benefit, Ignatz.
Why?
Imagine an incomparable beauty standing before you. Do you really think you'll be able to remain calm?
Well, that is to say...
But if I'm there, I can smooth things over. Have a nice chat, invite her to tea, everything a goddess deserves.
Oh, well, I suppose that makes sense.
Of course it does. Now, get on with it. Pray like you've never prayed before. As you can see, if we were to face an enemy on this terrain, I would go here, and you would go here.
Hang on. If we're trying to repel the enemy, I should be positioned there, correct?
Huh? I'm not sure that's the best idea. Take a closer look at this map. See? There's a graveyard over here. Might run into some of those ghosts you hate so much.
Claude, will you knock it off already? So help me. If you continue treating me like a child, I'll...
Easy there. I'm sorry, okay? Just don't start blasting off any spells in here.
I've more pride than to turn an unarmed soldier to cinders. It wouldn't kill you to speak to me as an equal when we're discussing matters as serious as this.
Actually, I see you as more than an equal. There's no questioning the power you wield. And I was being serious about the formation just now. The bit about the ghosts was just me having fun with you. Or trying to. You're so smart, I figured you'd catch on to that right away. But back to the formation. Can you see why I arranged it like I did? The area I want you to guard requires the ability to adapt to an ever-changing situation. Who else could I trust with such a difficult task? You're my best bet for something like that.
Perhaps that's true.
Think back to the times we fought together. When have I ever treated you like a child on the battlefield? I depend on you, Lysithia. I value your power almost as much as I do Teach's.
Truly?
I swear to you on all of Fodlan. I'd like to have my fun, but I wouldn't joke about something like that. I consider you a valued ally. I'll stop now before I inevitably drift back into teasing you again. Just know that I meant every word, okay?
Fair enough, then. From here forward, see to it that you treat me with the respect of an equal. And I admit that you are not short on talent yourself, but don't go getting a big head over it.
Says Lysithia, a head the size of a blimp that could be punctured so easily with a single word.
As expected, I am not finding anything at all.
Flame, are you looking for something in particular?
Oh, I was just hoping for general reading that might illustrate the lives of city dwellers.
Right. Well, there should be regional records somewhere around here.
I haven't need of official records or anything of the like. Just some light reading on the subject.
Light reading? What do you mean by that?
Oh, you know, books that cover things like what types of activities young people enjoy, how they spend their free time, popular fashions and trends, things of that sort. And even, perhaps, stories about romance?
Ah, I see what you're getting at. Try asking a traveling merchant. I hear they keep stock of books like that. As for here, I don't think you're gonna find much aside from a bunch of stuffy records. We do get new books donated on a fairly regular basis, but then Sedith, well, you know.
My brother? I am afraid I do not follow.
Apparently, he directly approves every book before it's allowed to grace these shelves. You know, to make sure nothing inappropriate gets through.
I see. I did not realize he had a hand in such things. Well, I suppose it really is no use searching here.
Why were you looking for those sorts of books anyway?
Well, truth be told, I am not particularly well-versed in the ways of ordinary people. Sedith never taught me of such things. And he strictly forbade me from spending much time out and about on my own.
Yeah, I had a feeling that might be the case. Sounds like Sedith.
I understand and appreciate that he acted from a place of concern, of course.
Without a doubt. It's obvious that you're his whole world, for better or worse. By the way, I've been wondering, are you two from a noble family?
Hmm?
You've clearly had a rather high-class upbringing, and both of you have crests. That can only mean you come from a prominent bloodline, right?
Of course not. No, you are mistaken.
So, your refined way of speaking isn't because of your upbringing?
I was not aware that my speech differed so greatly from my companions. Do I really sound so formal to you?
Well, look, don't worry too much about it. I'm probably just overthinking things. Probably.
Support. Cutscene's really gonna eat up the time. Fuck Lorenz, I don't care.
Oh, it's Raphael. What's he doing at that desk?
Being depressed.
Hey, are you studying? I thought you'd given up on it. Nice to see you. What the?
Oh, Leonie!
Oh, What's wrong? Why are you crying?
I just got a thank you letter from my little sister.
Okay, maybe start from the beginning.
My little sister lives with my grandpa now. She's had to deal with so much since I decided not to take over the family business.
You might have to back up a bit more before this starts to make sense to me.
Our parents were merchants, but they died in an accident. We had some money saved at first, but Grandpa isn't healthy enough to work, and I'm not smart enough to work a job that requires much thinking.
That's really tough. Hard to make a fortune with just your strength, I'm sure.
I had to sell all our valuables just to pay my way here so I could become a knight.
Wow, that's a lot of pressure.
My sister wants the best for me, but she's the smart one in the family. She's the one that should be here. When I ask if she needs anything, she always says she's fine. She doesn't want to ask me for anything because she knows I'm having such a hard time here.
She sounds like a great kid. So, what did the letter say?
It says she's happy and thankful for all the study materials I sent her.
That's good, right? Wait, where did you find extras?
I couldn't find any, so I just sent her mine. It's like you said, right? It's better to give them to someone who will use them instead of letting them go to waste.
Don't take this the wrong way, but don't you still kind of need those? Well, I guess if it makes her happy, it's worth it. Maybe I can scrounge something up for her too.
Sure, I could just give you a grand for some books.
Hey, Marianne? Are you there?
Yes. Can I help you?
Do you have a minute?
Huh? Oh, I...
Then, if you don't mind, would you come with me for a moment?
So, did you need something from me?
Yes, indeed. I have an urgent request.
Have I done something?
Oh, no, it's nothing like that. Really, you don't have to worry. Would you close your eyes, please?
Then how will I know where I'm going?
Just take my hand. That's it.
Ooh.
There, right there. Perfect. Now open your eyes.
Oh, the town is glowing from the sunset.
Yes. Isn't it beautiful?
Very much so.
I was looking at it earlier and I thought to myself, I have to show Marianne.
But why me?
Because you're always looking at your shoes. You never get a chance to appreciate the scenery.
Oh, I...
See, the best thing about the scenery is it's always changing, with the weather, the time of day, the season. So every view is unique, never to be repeated. If no one sees it, it's lost.
That windmill just reminds me of the umbrella symbol from Resident Evil.
You could have just enjoyed it on your own.
I wanted to share this beautiful landscape with you.
Thank you. I'm not sure what to say.
Hey, that's okay. I won't try to express this beauty in words either. Just look and remember. This will make for a nice memory. And maybe remember that I was here too.
I will. I really will.
Ignat's got the moves. Just needs the confidence now.
Who's there? Oh. Hey, Ignatz.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Relax. You're not interrupting.
I'm sorry. I didn't know you were training out here.
I sometimes come here to practice by myself. It's more like a real battlefield, you know? Shooting the targets in the yard lets you train your aim and all, but the tension just isn't the same.
You're right. A real battlefield feels quite different. But if that's the atmosphere you want, I feel even more like I'm intruding.
Oh, knock it off. You're already here. May as well stick around while I catch my breath.
Ah, okay, sorry. Thank you. Sorry to bother you.
You know you've said you're sorry about a dozen times since you got here.
Oh, I'm so... Ah.
It's fine. I guess it's part of your charm. Hey, what's that bundle of papers? Oh, did you come here to paint? I remember now. Someone said you're a great artist. You paint a lot, right?
Yes. Yes. When I have the time, that is. I enjoy painting. It helps me relax.
Oh, well, that could be your thing.
My thing? Huh? What do you mean?
Last time we talked about it, you said you didn't have a thing you were really amazing at. But if you like painting so much, it must be a skill you're looking to master.
My paintings are nothing but a hobby. Besides, I'm not that good. I never took art lessons. When I was little, I drew a picture for a young girl. The picture made her so happy that I decided to keep at it. That's how it started.
So you're practicing your art to make other people happy? Is that it?
Oh no, that's an overstatement. I must insist again, it's just a hobby. Even if I were to become a master artist, it wouldn't be a useful skill.
Aren't you from a merchant family employed by the nobles? I think it would be really useful there.
I'm not inheriting the business. My brother is. My father said that I'm to become a knight. So my art won't do anyone any good. At all. Ever.
Oh, Ignatz.
It was so sunny this morning.
Let's see if you're gonna get annoyed at Catherine.
It's absolutely pouring.
Did you hear the thunder just now? Good thing we got all the clothes indoors before the skies opened up. I apologize for troubling you with this task.
Don't worry about it. I was just passing by and thought I could help. I know how frustrating it is to have your newly dried clothes soaked by rain.
Oh.
What's wrong? We managed to keep all of the clothes dry, didn't we?
It's just... odd. Every time it's my turn to wash the clothing, there's a sudden downpour. Surely it must just be an inconvenient coincidence, but I can't help feeling as though I'm somehow to blame for it.
Ah, I see. That probably is your fault.
Wow. You're even harsher than I am.
You have a crest of Karen, don't you?
I do, yes, but... hold on a moment. How did you know that?
I can just tell. I have a crest of Karen, too. And I've noticed that, whenever I need dry weather, there's rain. Don't you think it's our crests making the rain fall upon us?
How had I never connected this? This is quite a revelation. A crest affecting the weather.
Well, I don't know how true it is. There are only the two of us, which is a pretty small sample of people.
I suppose that's true. So, we must test our hypothesis. Maybe we can find someone who tends to bring the sunshine around. That would be especially handy for helping out with the wash.
Now there's an idea.
They'd be great for farmers.
You've been an enormous help. Thanks so much. Excuse me. I have some more supplies that just arrived for the infirmary. Oh, were there more? I thought I'd gotten them all. I just have bandages and other small things, but there might be more coming. Well, I just got the boys to bring in the heavy bottles. Looks like we can't fit all of it without some rearranging, though. You know, if you'd arrived earlier, you could have helped me tidy up. My apologies. I don't really need your apologies. I need your help. Oh, okay. How can I help? How can you help? I said tidy up, didn't I? See the shelves there? See if you can clear out some space and tuck away the bandages. I can try. Ah! Hey, careful, Marianne. There's some strong stuff in those bottles. I'm sorry, I... No, look, just leave the bandages for now and move the bottles from the shelf. I can do that. Now the bandages fell. No! So in the end, I did it all by myself.
What a shame.
I'm sorry that I was no help. I just got in your way.
It's fine. We'll even it out with pastries.
You want me to get you pastries? I guess I can.
You seem so thoughtful and composed, but you're surprisingly clumsy. It's such an odd mix. I practically have no choice but to take over for you.
You're right. I'm sorry.
Okay, then. There's so many more to go through. But I think that's where I'm going to leave off for today. Almost got through the week. Next time I'll be starting off with the last two paralog battles and probably get some more next time. Though it seems like either this month doesn't have 31 days or the mission is just very early. It kicks off my last 3 week. It seems like I only have three weeks to do with what I wish. Or three weeks. I don't know if that's intentional, if it's whatever. A few more streams until tutorial is done. Oh boy! I could just have my character kill everyone. Come level 99. That'll be where I'm leaving this off for today. Next stream is going to be on Saturday, where we do some more Final Fantasy D20. Then Tuesday, going back to Code Vein, depending on what happens with, Elden Ring. I don't know if Brisson's gonna lose his nerve, and lose his inhibitors for that, and just buy it. And then back to Pathfinder and Fire Emblem next Thursday. So I shall thank everybody for watching. If I don't see you any of those days, I shall see you all next time.